Hello and welcome to the video lesson, Development Simulation of a Mini Collection of Prints. This session is entitled Contests for Printed Fabric Design. For designers, color is yet another tool to be used to achieve an end. Some designers who got specialized in color-related work developed their work as stylists, fashion consultants, color consultants, or even color predictors. It is known for a fact that color plays a major role in textile printing design, for the color of the fabric is always the first thing that customer perceives. Second is the pattern, and finally the motif or imagery used in the design. Fabrics are usually available in more than one set of colorway. Therefore, the designer needs to have the necessary skill to replace one set of colors for another one, but maintaining the design identity. Colors are generally associated to seasonal palettes that are presented by trend forecasters in order to give a general idea of the colors that will be used in the following season. These events normally occur twice a year during textile and apparel fairs, where these forecast reports are presented to industry professionals. One of the most known fairs in Europe is the Première Vision and occurs in February and in September in Paris. Textile characteristics are one of the biggest concerns if a quality print is to be achieved, as it will strongly depend on the various interactions between the type of ink and fabric, namely, printing ink diffusion is influenced by ink properties, fiber types, fabric construction characteristics, and pretreatments applied prior to the printing on the textile substrate. The textile characteristics we should be taking into consideration are yarn size, fabric structure, and hydrophilic nature of the fabric. Fabric structure is a characteristic which most influences print quality, for, unlike paper, fabric is a three-dimensional substrate. It is common knowledge that plain weave fabrics, followed by twill and sateen woven fabrics, have the best performance, whereas knitted fabric has the lowest. Another concern to be taken into account is color gamut, which varies with different textile materials. Printing on fabric can expressively alter the visual appearance of the textile. Fashion designers select their prints, while print designers produce them directly, though it is useful to be able to separate the range of processes and printing techniques that exist nowadays, which can mostly be divided between digital and analogic processes, as seen in the slide. For some designers, the use of some specific type of print or characteristic pattern can become a defining feature of their personal style. Silk screen printing, also named serigraphy, is a much more ancient technique that can be manual or mechanic. Mechanic silk screen printing is usually linear, where the fabric or garment enters and exits the machine in line after being subjected to several coats. On the other hand, it can be circular, where the garment or fabric rotates under each screen, which apply different colors and patterns in order to obtain the final composition. In each case, the way silkscreen printing works, it's quite simple. Let's take a t-shirt as an example. For each color that I want to introduce on the design, a different screen is going to be used. As each screen is set for a color, the design of the color is represented on the screen. The structure will only let the color go through the areas that are open, just like a stencil will do. Pay attention to the representation on the right. The screens are represented in blue, and the first screen is for black ink. The second is for the indigo ink. Final result is by color. Only two screens were necessary for this design, as only two colors were represented here. Remember that for each color, a different screen is necessary. Each screen is made to only let the ink get through the microscopic holes that represent the shapes and forms for each color. Now, On the digital printing technique, it can be regarded as very close to a digital paper printer, as you can see on the slide. Once the fabric is inserted into the machine, everything is directly controlled by a computer and done automatically. You just have to prepare the design and make sure it is adequate for the fabric's base color. In our case, for a white or black t-shirt, colors should be vibrant enough to distinguish themselves from the base color. This direct application on a textile piece of cloth, or even in a pattern, is commonly known as direct to garment or direct to fabric. However, we must be aware that there are two main branches in digital textile printing. One is known as direct to garments printing, and it's based upon inkjet printing on fabrics. The other method is named sublimation inkjet printing, thought to be the major technique used within DTP. Digital textile printers apply the image directly on the fabric roll mounted in the machine. These machines usually print on light fabrics. However, some can be used to print on darker shades, but the ink applied must be darker than the base color. The digital textile printer must be correctly calibrated considering the fabric width, the fabric composition itself, as well as the design applied on it. If the design is a pattern, it should be calibrated to fit and repeat correctly, as seam lines cannot appear in the final work. The most important application fields in digital textile printing, particularly inkjet printing, have been so far the pre-printing, proofing and sampling, and small run printing, also referred as agile manufacturing model. More recently, with the technological advances in industrial printing machines, DTP began to reach production speed and reliabilities for robust bulk production, whereby some medium-scale production prints are already being done with this technology, with similar quality and a very competitive price when compared with the traditional analog method of rotary screen printing, particularly for series smaller than 1000 meters. Digital textile printers are therefore used in several industries, and they can be used to produce textiles for fashion, interior design, furniture design, and all sorts of industries. A systematic classification of DTP can be made based upon product end use, as seen as in the slide. And that concludes our lesson. I'm hoping that you enjoy it. Thank you so much for your time and attention.